if that's what it is. Mm-hmm. You're not limited by the machine really in mm-hmm. anything. Mm-hmm. You know, you can do any kind of cut of any type in any type of material. Mm-hmm. You can hold any type of material.
So what kinds of things?
Because machining is always a challenge.
Right.
How do I hold this thing?
Right.
How do I apply a cutter to it at some particular direction yeah. or angle?
Yeah.
And with this design, almost anything solvable that's just limited by your imagination.
So what kinds of things would you say you could make with it if you're just thinking about things you could make?
You could make any three-dimensional shape, mm-hmm. save for things that have internal honeycombing, say, mm-hmm. which are better suited to another method like 3D printing.
Mm-hmm.
So, but if your method of dealing with the object is to remove material from it mm-hmm. in any way, what's nothing better than this? And a lathe sandy too does much the same thing. It removes material from a thing, mm. leaves you with less than you started, like sculpture.
Mm-hmm.
And machining is akin to sculpture in a way.
Mm.
You know, you want to plan out your next place to go womp, unless you know when the arm fall off, say. So you got to understand the material and its propensities, you know, stuff like that. And then, like, things can be figured out. That's what I found. That's why the millet I bought proved to be such a thing in my shop. Like, I could imagine when I bought it, oh, I'll have uses for this.
Mm.
Then as time went on, it seemed like any use that came up,
mm.
like the guy with the hammer where everything's a nail now, it's like, I'll go to the mill. Mm-hmm. I'll go to the mill.
Yeah.
And why? Because it offered greater precision, it more securely held things, you could get a clear view of what you were doing, it was safe. You know, I knew if I raised the table 3/1000ths of an inch. In fact, that's exactly what it did.
Mm.
Whereas woodworking machines do not offer you that confidence.
Yeah.
So
mention a few things right now just on here that you did with that mill that were useful with the Zimmerman.
Well, for example, on the cabinet downstairs, all the zigzag lattice work was done with Zimmerman. And it had to have very precise distances between the lap joints.
Mm-hmm.
That was possible on a mill because I could go exact distances. Also, I'm able to do things where in woodworking, I would take fiber board or other materials to make a jig to hold a thing and execute mm-hmm. certain cuts.
Yeah.
Instead of that, I can be more direct. Really, the issue is how do I mount this to the machine and execute the cuts? You know?
So yeah.
You I like the directness and I don't have to work with materials I don't like. Like who likes fiber board?
Yeah. You also did the feet.
That's right. Plus it handles a multiplicity of materials, non-ferrous metals, cast iron, steel, titanium, plastics, mm-hmm. wood. I mean, woodworking machines do not offer that.
Yeah.
You can do it to a limited extent. You can, like on a table saw, you can cut aluminum.
Mm-hmm.
Makes a heck of a noise. You can cut brass on a table saw or with a router. As soon as you get into those materials, the risks go up.
Yeah.
Because, like, brass and bronze are grabby. When the cutter comes into them, it tends to want to stick and grab. It's less safe if you're having to hold the tool while it's howling away. Yeah. Not only can it catch it and throw the stuff, but make a mess of the piece you're working on.
Mm.
So those are some of the advantages.
That's great. So sky's the limit is what you're saying.
Yeah, that's why I like the machine because it's just one design a milling machine, but it offers so many advantages over the other types of designs that I've experienced and seen. And it's clear to me it offered higher potential. Yeah.
Sorry you won't get to use it.
Me too.
I know you would have done really cool stuff with it. All right.